Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Rocket Monday. In today's episode, we're gonna try to understand this new hype that's going around China's artificial moon. So let's dive right into it to understand it. So what the heck is happening? Basically, this whole idea is to save money. Like in as you can realize, there is a lot of money that is invested to make sure you have street lamps and, you know, night lights and, you know, save energy. They're gonna create an artificial moon. In this scenario, the target group, like where they're gonna focus their effort, is Chiangdong province. Basically, this is a area where they're gonna focus it. So basically, they're gonna make an artificial moon, not for the whole planet, but for a focused reason, that being the region. And the target, when this will be done, is 2020. So many of you understand, it's like, what? So what is happening in reality, it's, well, who knows, because this sort of story I've been hearing for 10 years. In my old days, as in like when I was in school, there was like a rumor China developed a car that runs on 1 hour. Then there was this China is gonna soon develop a completely new star. We're gonna soon have two suns. So it's on the same vein. Now, what's really happening, it's basically old Soviet project. Soviet, not Russian. Basically, there is a very blurry line here. Is that when Russia was created, they had a very advanced space program. In that program, there was a attempt to make what we call solar cell. So this was the attempt, and it's quite big. This is the Soyuz capsule. So not Soyuz exactly, but to get understand you the size, this is quite big. So they tried to make it and understand the dynamics of it, but this from vantage point of Earth looked like this, basically a satellite flare. So this is what has been revived. Like, this is what I can confirm, like this whole idea of making artificial moon comes from this data point. So basically, they're gonna use solar sail, and from vantage point of Earth, it's gonna look like there is an artificial star. Like these sort of flare is iridium flares, as they used to be called. But iridium satellites now being, you know, not deorbited, and their lifespan is about to end. So China is trying to create a moon. So let's understand the whole idea of it. So can it be done? Yes, it's a very simple thing. All you have to do is put something like this. This is a solar sail concept, and this is the size of a human, like this small compared to human. This is quite big, and this packs up into a very small volume. So what China is trying to do is gonna be super huge, like hundreds of meter to kilometer, like 2 to 3 kilometer is target size to achieve enough illumination. Now they were saying it's gonna be 10 times brighter than moon. Now, is it possible? Yes, because you are not carrying your own energy. You are, bouncing the energy from sun. It's, again, very easy. Second, the moon is around 1.8 second light away. So it's surprisingly far away. And moon is very dark, as in its albedo, as in how bright it is, practically speaking. It's very dark. It's more or less like a pavement road. It's not very bright. However, if you have something that is closer to Earth, as in like a geostationary orbit, which is only 30,000 kilometers far apart, even a normal mirror will reflect enough light back that to our eye, it will perceive very bright. So it is doable. And not to mention, the thing you have to understand is that our eye is logarithmic. Basically, it does not go from, like, you know, 10 to 11 to 12 to 13 in terms of sensitivity. It goes in basically more or less like a camera where, you know, you have ISO 800 to ISO 1600 to less. So we jump logarithmically. That's why your eye can adjust even in moonlight. So if they bump up the energy output, as in basically make this sail bigger, they can focus enough area in large enough section that it will appear that you are in, like, you know, cloudy, kind of dull. It won't be daylight. Don't worry about it. It will never be as bright as daylight. However, it is quite easy to exceed that brightness of full bright moon very easily because of the fact that you are closer to Earth. So as in, you are not losing a lot of energy trying to reflect it. Second, you are reflecting it with very efficient material, as in, like, these things are quite reflective to 98% of electromagnetic spectrum in the visual range. So it is doable. From physics standpoint, it's very easily doable. Now be mindful, because this is a solar sail, you have to have thrusters on this sort of thing. You cannot have this as in like, okay, I just put it there and forgot about it. Not only you need thrusters for station keeping, you also need thruster to compensate for the thrust that these sails will generate. Now, if you make them big, it's gonna have bigger thrust. Now, in small scale like this, they have very little amount of thrust. You don't have to worry too much about it. But if you make it, let's say, hundreds to 1 kilometer size, now it has enough thrust that you actually have to spend enough propellant to keep it in the same orbit. Otherwise, it's gonna drift apart. And you need that to, you know, align the angle basically so it reflects the sunlight in one position. This is also crucial. Like, they are not targeting to make a second moon for the whole planet, they are targeting to illuminate that one area. So that's the whole point. They're gonna have a giant solar sail, they're gonna need a it's not necessary that they're gonna need ion propulsion, but they could use something similar to that. Because now be mindful, take all of this with a giant grain of salt, because this sort of news article I have been reading for like 10-20 years at this point. So I'm just telling you, physics does not block you. And to properly do coverage of one spot, you need two geostationary satellites. Because even though geostationary satellite remains, you know, during its orbit of 24 hours, it remains in the sunlight for most of the time, but it still does go through the shadow of Earth. While that time, you have to make sure there is another satellite, you know, that is still in the sun side, and you know, it's now reflecting. So if you have two, then you can ensure 24/7 coverage. Basically, whole night coverage of that area would be illuminated. Physics is not stopping you. However, there is no reason to do it. There is no practical point of doing it. It's just something like, of course, I think they are trying to revive the solar sail concept because it has a potential benefit in long-term space exploration, but not to make a, you know, artificial moon. So there is a bit of grain of truth, but giant truck of salt. So let's say it can be done. Let's say you have the money to do it. Should we do it? Hell no, because there are serious danger with this. Now, this image is a I have provided the link down below. This is an image of light pollution, you know, on a global scale. To try to you know, watch the largest size of this image is 200 megabyte image. So it's kind of big, and you have a lot of resolution in this. Light pollution is becoming severe. Now you might be like, okay, who cares? You care from the point of view that you are wasting energy. You have to care about money, so you know, wasting energy is not wise. Second, it's very destructive to ecology and psychology of humans. Now, let's say you don't care about ecology, as in what would that matter? As many of you know, moths or all the insects that try to, you know, go around light bulbs, they do that because they are genetically programmed, as in their navigation system is moon navigation. So they see a bright spotlight and they move according to it. Now, they are only calibrated against moon and stars. Now, stars are nowhere near the brightness of a moon, so that's how they can make sure they are fully navigated. However, you introduce artificial light. Now, of course, your light is nowhere near as you know, powerful as moon brightness, but due to it being closer to the you know, insect, from insect's vantage point, it looks like the moon. So it tries to navigate using that. Now, of course, it's a false data point, and it tries to, you know, go around circle and circle. So now you might be like, okay, I don't care about insect, but again, do you will you not care if your whole city is getting swarmed by insect? Because if they try to do that, spot luminous, let's say this area of United Kingdom, the whole insect from hundreds of kilometers nearby, they will spot this and just try to navigate using that. So your whole city, wherever you are focusing this light, will be swarmed by insect. Not necessarily, like if it's very directional, it may not happen, but if you have cloud, fog or things of that nature, yes, then this will happen. So, and ecology matters. Like, your food crops come from ecology. If ecology is damaged, your food will be very, very expensive, if you are lucky. If you're unlucky, there won't be any food. So, and not to mention, even if you don't care about that, you have to care about people's psychology. You don't want Mad Max scenario. You want people to be calm and, you know, thoughtful. If people are put in a situation where they have 24/7 illumination, their psychology breaks down. Our brain is built, you know, day on night cycle. It needs that. It's not a choice of, oh, I am strong, manly man who can, like, you know, function 24/7. Yeah, for 1 or 2 days, you can't exceed that for a long enough time. And let's say this China actually does this, and you know, this actually happens for a long enough time, people will go crazy in that area. Smart people will run away from that city, because no job is worth, you know, losing your mind. And and there is a very serious side effect to children, simply because in our body we have what we call hormones, and hormones have growth hormones and other architecture. Now there is no clock inside us, there is no, you know, clock that is running, okay, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 20 minutes. What we have is on off switch. Now that on off switch is triggered by light. So if you open your eyes and there is a lot of light that is happening in the day, your valve system is open and it only closes when you go to sleep. So in earlier days it was very common because there was no artificial lighting, so that light period could not be stretched. However, with modern time, due to light pollution, children are hitting puberty much early because their growth hormone valves is remaining open much longer. So our days went from 12 hours to 18 hours day. So that hormone system is being online for much longer period. So every day you are adding 2-3 hours extra. So over time, let's say over a period of 12-13 years, you can see boys and girls, like, they literally look like 20 years old when they are barely 15 years old. That's happening because light pollution is screwing up their hormone system, specifically growth hormone, and this is very prominent with girls. It's not as obvious with boys, but in girls you can easily tell, like, 10 year old girl would look like a 20 year old girl. Like, it's day and night difference. And in boys, like, their aggression, their psychology, they all changes. Their voice deepens much earlier than it's supposed to. So there is a very serious downside of this to human anatomy. And you might be like, okay, they are maturing earlier, that's not bad. Well, it is bad. It's basically like before your operating system is installed, you start to run programs on it. It's a bad idea. So if you care about human sanity, make sure none of this sort of project is ever taken seriously or ever done. So, and this image I would urge you to watch, so you can get a very clear idea of the current status of the globe, because this image is from 2017 and NASA just released it to the public, not today as in recently. So this was my hopeful analysis that helped you to understand this artificial moon, and I hope you liked it or learned from it. In that case, please leave a like. If you didn't like it, you can dislike it. I would urge you to leave a comment what you want to see in the next episode of Rocket Monday, and please subscribe, press the bell icon if you're free, and as always, thanks for watching.